Great evening, everybody. This is Minister Sharon Wash, and I am here to give you another edition of Wild Out in the Word. Look, I was very excited about what the Lord said unto me to tell you today. Well, he told me to tell you that he is changing your story. So we're going to jump right in today. You know, Saul, anybody remember Saul in the Bible? He was a persecutor of the church. He breathed out cruelties, all of these things. He would bring Christians bound into Jerusalem. So he was asking the king to let him go to Damascus. So the king granted his wish. And as he was on his way to Damascus, a great bright light shined down from heaven on Saul and asked him from that great light. He didn't see a man or anything, but he heard a voice saying, "Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me?" Oh, my, my, my. Then he began to question. He said, Who are you? He says, "I am the Lord whom thou persecutest." Well, he was persecuting the Christians, so he didn't think there was any harm in that. But sometimes when we do things, we don't realize that we're kicking against God and his plan and his purpose. But God has come to change your story, even as he changed Saul's story. He even changed Saul's story to the point where he changed his name from Saul to Paul. And look, Paul, throughout the New Testament, after he was converted, because God changed his story from being a persecutor of the church to being a deliverer of the word of God. Hallelujah. That's a reason to shout right there. Because just like Paul, he didn't know. He didn't know how great God would use him in the end. It doesn't matter today how you start out, but it's all about how you finish. And I'm telling you, God is changing your story. So it doesn't matter how old you are, how weak you are, how young you are, or how much you think that it's all over. It's no reason to try any harder. Yes, it is, because God can use your story to change other people's lives. Even as he used Saul in the Bible, even as he used David in the Bible, who was a shepherd boy. His father didn't even consider him, didn't even know he was raising a king in his house. Hallelujah, somebody. But I tell you, God is changing your story. What he's doing is he's rearranging the pieces of your life. They've been all in shambles, spread out here, spread out there. This happened. You had some highs, you had some lows. But I tell you, it takes all of that to make you the person that God has called you to be. So today, I tell you, God is changing your story. Doesn't matter how long you've been in any situation that you're in, how lonely you felt, how down, how depressed. I tell you, the Lord was with you every step of the way, and he has come to change your story, which ultimately will change your life. And he will use your life as a witness to help change somebody else's story. So just like Paul was a persecutor of the church, now he had become a converter of the Gentiles, because the Lord sent him unto the Gentiles to preach the Lord Jesus Christ. And I tell you, it works the same way. God is no respecter of persons. So he wants to change your story. Do you believe today? Do you believe today that it doesn't matter where you are going up from here, up with faith, out with doubt, and down with unbelief, because God wants to change your story? Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come humbly before you right now, asking, oh God, first that you would keep us ever at your feet. Lord, no matter what our situations may bring to us in life, help us to always look unto the hills from which cometh our help. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that our latter end will be greater than where we've already been, Lord Jesus. We thank you for the ups and the downs that you allowed us to have in this life, Lord Jesus, that it all is working together for our good, because you want to change our story. thank you, Lord Jesus, for granting us the grace to trust you even in this season. We bless your name today and forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name we do pray. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you, and I look forward to joining you again with another edition of Wild Out in the Word. Blessings.